Welcome everyone. This is just going to be a quick guide for anyone who's trying to do a 360 video through Insta 360 Studio, and it'll show you how to make a 360 degree interactive video to put up on YouTube. Now, this does make a really good 360 video that plays in VLC, and you can upload it to YouTube, but YouTube doesn't quite support it very well. I'll show you what I mean in a second. It doesn't zoom right, it zooms in really close and you lose a lot of interactivity. But first I'll show you how to process a video and then I'll show you the two comparisons. So VLC versus what actually happens once it hits YouTube. So open Insta 360, import your file as you normally would, grab the LRV file. This is just a quick example. Leave it in view. Then click the export icon in the top right corner. Set your resolution. I usually just leave it on the default, which was 5760. Crank the bitrate right up to 200. Leave your frame rate. Leave the encoding format. Leave the export type as video. And remove grain works pretty good. So I would do that and then just click OK. And then obviously you just gotta wait for it to export, which can take a little while depending on your computer. Okay, so now the file is completed. You can close out. Okay, so it took me a while to see where I saved the file to, but that's it here. And you can open these files with VLC. So we'll just open it. And that's what it'll look like fully zoomed in, which is what it'll end up looking like on YouTube. However, with VLC, you can zoom right back out and get full 360 control. So I'll show you another video that will actually be a better example. So this is one I recorded on my bike a while back. Again, this is what it'll look like on YouTube. But if you zoom out, you get the proper footage. However, once you've uploaded it to YouTube, it will generally look like this. So it's interactive, but you can't zoom out. Kind of looks terrible. Now, as far as I'm aware, I've looked around, there's no other option to adjust this. This is just how it is. YouTube doesn't have a zoom out feature, so you're gonna lose most of the quality you've had in your original video. As you can see, it grains up. But if you aren't using it for YouTube, yeah, it's actually really good footage. Again on YouTube. We'll do a side-by-side comparison. Anyway, that's it for this one. It's not really too difficult. It's not really that great to put on YouTube either, but there you go. That's how you do it, and hopefully it solves a few issues for you. Anyway, as always, thanks for watching. See you next time.